Yes, I'm next. My name is Matt Hagler, and I know most of us, if not all of us, live here in Middle Tennessee, and we've all kind of probably had some friends come into town, and their first thing they want to do is go to the Honkyonks. That's probably not the first place that we want to take them or hang out. So, being kind of a new resident, less than 2 years, it's also somewhere that I felt like I needed to go check out. And maybe put together a little field guide on where you should take your friends or why not you should take them there. So, obviously this is a very common place we all know very well. I'm going to start on the southern, or I guess on the northernmost part, and I hit up the stage first. This is 1 week ago today, and 5:30 p.m., so a little over a week. You notice PBR bottle is $4, and I think we have more people than they did at this time, so that's good. You can see right here, there's 20, 30 people, and you know, they're in and out. Their kind of like motif there was collection of kind of random guitars. I don't know if they have any significance at all, or if they're just, you know, already smarty. But I did meet some really interesting people. This is Pierre, Daniel, and Peter. They are three Swiss guys. You can notice they're checking out the local delicacies. Yazoo Belle and Petrificio Fire. That hopefully is back in Switzerland now. The guy in the middle, his daughter is an IndyCar racer. They're in town on their way to Dallas after the Indy 500. Roberts, this one, 5 stars, this is my favorite. It took me a while to touch them, so an hour later we're here. I think PBR is like $2 there, but I got a recession special, that's what they called it. And I had a hot dog, a PBR, a bag of Lay's, and a moon pie for $5. So that's the place to go if you're ever hungry. Probably that's the best deal. They got a kitchen. This place, they will not let you play music unless you play like the classic stuff. And this guy, Pappy, as everyone calls him there, his band has played there every Monday night since July of 2001. And he was featured on Grand Ole Opry for 24 years. He's played with Roy Acuff, Patsy Cline, you name it. He's been there. He's awesome. One of the best fiddle guys. Round three, we're at Layla's. It's funny that no one's heard of this place. You walk by it all the time. So, a little 2 stars.
Yeah.
But they had a good deal. $250, and that was solid. $250. But you had to have a $10 minimum on a card. So, I was kind of a little fast-paced. I didn't want to stay there for $10 worth. They had a little bit more, like, kind of a rock country vibe in here. But, like, their little motif, kind of how the stage had guitars. They've got this whole license plate thing going on. And there's some fun ones, but I realize that the stipulation there is you got to dress like their logo to play there, or I don't think they'll let you in. There's a little hot, so I think he had already taken his band down by the time I got there. But it's still a pretty fun place for cheaper beers. And then second fiddle, we moved on, or I moved on to, I guess I was doing this alone. They got $4, but it's at least a tall boy, so you're getting a little bit more bang for your buck. Like here, they have tall boys for $3.75, so the Rutledge does have second fiddle beat. It's a little empty there, though. They had some fun music, but you know, it's really hard to get into it when you're the only person there. But they had a pretty cool collection, and I kind of realized that was a thing. Like all through the bars, they've all have like something they try to collect and show off. So their whole thing was like all the radios and jukeboxes. So like that was pretty cool. Just kind of starting to see these patterns through all the honky tonks and how they are similar and different in at the same time. Moving on down the street, we're at Tootsie's. Notice that was only a 30-minute transition. I was not staying at second fiddle alone for a while. This is probably the most expensive place you're going to find down there, but it's usually pretty jam-packed. And I think one of my friends here said that you can't go there and not spend $100 on a weekend. One of the cool things is the TV up here, I don't really know the significance of it, but it's a live feed of their other Tootsies in Pier Park in Florida. Just in case you want to be there. But they have two stages at this place, and that's Miss Tootsie. I'm going to say I really don't know her significance, so maybe someone can fill me in later. But she seemed to be pretty important because they gave her two stages instead of one on the street. She's cute today. And so finally, we're at Legends, and sorry, I forgot to take a picture of the front. Just at this time, drinking a beer at all the places you forget what you're doing. But it was pretty fun. They had, you know, it was pretty packed. It's getting later in the night. And they also had a big collection of guitars, kind of like the stage did, so it kind of got this bookend of guitar things. But nobody has this. And so that right there is good enough reason to go there, besides the music or the beers or the collections or anything else. Nobody has Billy Ray Cyrus on their tour. So I really enjoyed that. Also, one of the most unique guitars I've ever seen in my life. This is back by the bathrooms, if you guys are ever there. They got him over there too, just in case you need money for a cab ride home or anything like that. Or maybe another bar here. And I think at this point, I think we might have a beer break coming up, in fact. Is that right? So, this is a little...
have like a 15-minute beer break, bathroom break, and then we'll be back.